What is your worst match, according to your zodiac sign? Zodiac signs can have a huge impact on whether two people are compatible long-term. Some people have a naturally harmonious relationship because their zodiac signs are compatible. On the flip side, some combinations are simply disastrous for both parties involved. These signs tend to approach love and relationships from very different angles in a way that's not at all complementary. One of the two signs might desire companionship and commitment, while the other wants to feel free and unconstrained. One of the two signs is honest, while the other has a penchant for exaggerating the truth. One of the two is hardworking and the other prioritizes having a good time. These combinations usually lead to heartbreak and stress for both parties involved. The best thing you can do is to end these relationships whenever possible. You'll do yourself and the other person a favor, and you'll avoid wasting time. Without any further ado, here are the worst pairings of the zodiac, starting with Sagittarius and Cancer. Sagittarius is an adventurous sign who is constantly looking to get out of their comfort zone. They like to feel free, even within a committed relationship. On the other hand, there's Cancer. Cancers are homebodies who love being in places that give them comfort. They are happy to hang out with the same people over and over again. They also like to have some ground rules in their relationships so they know exactly what to expect from their partner. Do you see where they start to clash? Sagittarius will get bored with Cancer, and they might also start to feel suffocated by their rules. Cancer, on the other hand, will feel that Sagittarius is too restless and that they can't keep up their pace. They think Sagittarius lacks empathy because they dislike having ground rules. When the outlooks are so different, it's best to not even try. Moving on, Aquarius and Taurus. Aquarius is all about holding on to things, people, and situations too tightly. They go with the flow and are prepared to let go when necessary. On the other hand, there's Taurus. Taurus has a hard time letting go of things. When in doubt, they'd rather keep people, things, and situations in their lives. Letting go is one of the hardest challenges for Taurus. The match between Aquarius and Taurus is simply disastrous because they're both stubborn to boot. No party will want to compromise on their point of view. Aquarius will keep pushing Taurus to let go, and Taurus will insist on keeping business as usual. Routines are deadly for Aquarius and essential for Taurus. Taurus will resent Aquarius for making them feel boring and predictable just for living their lives. Aquarius will also feel constrained by Taurus's more possessive tendencies, and Taurus will fail to understand Aquarius's tendencies to treat their lovers as friends. Taurus will think Aquarius doesn't love them because they give them so much freedom, and Aquarius will feel they are being treated as an object by Taurus. It's not a story that will end well for either party. Moving on, Virgo and Aries. Cold-hearted Virgo knows how to strategize and plan without being influenced by their emotions. Then, there's spontaneous, emotional, and explosive Aries. Virgo will want to plan their dates in advance, and Aries will resent the lack of spontaneity. Virgo's sense of routine will seem oppressive to them. In turn, Virgo will start to get critical of Aries's impulsiveness, and it will end in endless arguments and resentment. Virgo is also very devoted to their partner and likes to give all of themselves when they are in a relationship, whereas Aries tends to be more self-centered. Virgo will get upset because their devotion isn't being properly reciprocated. Aries, in turn, will feel insulted by Virgo's perseverance in trying to change them. There will be a lot of misunderstandings between them despite their mutual preference for direct communication, as Aries's emotions will cloud their judgment, and Virgo's frustrations will make them less receptive to what the other person has to say. Overall, a recipe for disaster. Moving on, Capricorn and Leo. Capricorn and Leo both value their reputations, and they are both great at being assertive. But that's where the similarities end. Capricorn is all work and no play, And Leo is one of the zodiac signs who value their downtime and fun the most. Their priorities will never be aligned. Leo will think that Capricorn is a workaholic, and Capricorn will think that Leos need to get their priorities straight. To add insult to injury, Capricorn will find Leo dramatic and annoying, whereas Leo will think Capricorns are too rigid. Neither sign is known for their abilities at self-sacrifice and compromise. This will lead to endless conflict. They will both resent each other and fail to appreciate each other's qualities. They will over-fixate on each other's weaknesses, which will end up affecting both of their self-esteem. While sexual chemistry can exist between these two signs, it won't work for long. Moving on, Libra and Scorpio. Libra loves to be well-liked. They are charming and have people-pleasing tendencies. In contrast, Scorpio loves to stir up controversy and talk about taboo topics as one discusses the weather. Just 10 minutes into a conversation, Libra will start to feel uneasy, and Scorpio will think Libra is too accommodating and has a weak character. Libra can be pretty passive-aggressive too, and this won't fly with Scorpio, who prefers a more direct communication style. A relationship between Libra and Scorpio is a toxic mess in which Libra is constantly wasting their energy and time in amending Scorpio's reputation, even though Scorpio could not care less about it. To top it all off, Scorpio will get jealous at Libra's flirty personality. They won't understand they can't help but be charming. Couple these two up, and heartbreak will be on the horizon. Moving on, Gemini and Pisces. Pisces puts great stock in empathy and listening to others. You might think that Gemini has found a sympathetic ear to listen to their never-ending chatter, but think again. Gemini likes freedom and unpredictability. While Pisces can easily deliver unpredictability, freedom will be more complex. Pisces needs to be coddled and showered with love, which doesn't mesh well to Gemini's more rational approach to love. Gemini will find Pisces' emotional needs exhausting, and Pisces will end up thinking Gemini is cold-hearted and doesn't actually love them. To make matters even worse, Pisces is constantly portraying themselves as the victim, even if Gemini is not objectively doing anything objectively wrong. When Gemini tries to discuss their problems in a rational manner, Pisces will get defensive and start bursting out crying to the amazement of Gemini. Overall, a disastrous combination. If you have fallen in love with your first match, don't despair. We are more than our sun sign. You must also look at your lover's moon sign, Mercury and Venus. Perhaps they turn out to be compatible. The best thing you can do in order to determine compatibility is getting a synastry chart reading from an astrologer. Do you agree with these though? Have you ever dated your worst match? Did it go wrong or did you find happiness together? Do you know of any success stories or do these pairings always end up in disaster? Tell us in the comments. Thank you for watching the video. Please like, share, and subscribe to get all the updates.